Hi students, this is the second video of factor and remainder theorem. Now we are continuing with classwork sum number 3. Classwork sum number 3 on page 191. Now the question given, this is your f of x. So the polynomial given, we call it as f of x. That is equal to x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4x minus 12. What is the maximum degree? It is 3. So you will get sums of 3 degree only because factorization of 2 degree you did last year. So that is, you will get third degree sum. So when you get this sum, which is a third degree polynomial, firstly you should know that there will be 3 factors and 3 solutions. So now, if the question given is, find all the 3 factors, then the first factor we have to find by trial and error method. And after we find the first factor by trial and error method, the remaining factors we can find by synthetic division method. So now how to find the first factor? In this polynomial, the constant term is minus 12. Since minus 12 is the constant term, we have to first see what are the factors of minus 12. The factors of minus 12 are plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, plus minus 4, plus minus 6, and plus minus 12. Now, since these are the factors of 12, therefore, we have to do trial and error and see what is f of 1. Does it come equal to 0? Then if that doesn't come equal to 0, then we have to see what is f of minus 1. Does that come equal to 0? Then f of 2, does that come equal to 0? Usually in the first or second attempt itself, that is on one or two itself, you will get that one of them is the factor. So we are doing trial and error method. We substitute f of 1. So in this equation, we substitute x is equal to 1. So we get, when you substitute it is minus 12, it is not equal to 0. Same way, after that we are trying minus 1. So when we substitute minus 1 and check it out, we will see that minus 1 is also not giving f of minus 1 is minus 6, it is not equal to 0. So none of these are factors of the given polynomial. Next you try for f of 2. When you try for f of 2, we see that f of 2, the remainder is 0. So what does that mean? You had written remainder theorem, factor theorem. It says that x is equal to 2, therefore x minus 2 is a factor of f of x. So we have found the first factor by using trial and error method. Now we know that x minus 2 is a factor of f of x. So we use the division method to find the remaining factors. When you do the division method, make sure that all the plus minus signs are properly written. Usually mistakes are made in that. I purposely have not solved that. We will do it together so that you can understand what this division method is. So now you have x minus 2. Here you have to write a number so that that number when multiplied by x should give you x cube plus x cube. So what will I write there? Obviously it has to be x squared. If you write x squared here, x squared into x gives you x cubed. But then you have to multiply the second term also. So minus 2 into x squared will give you minus 2x squared. So now you have to subtract these both from these. So when you subtract, the sign changes. So this becomes 0 and this becomes plus 5x squared. You have to bring the next term down. So what you will write down is minus 4x. So now you have to write and get 5x squared here. So if you have to get 5x squared here, then obviously the number that you multiply with x to get 5x squared here, out here it has to be 5x. Why? 5x into x will give you 5x squared. Then next, you have to multiply minus 2 with 5x. So minus 2 with 5x is minus 10x. So now again this has to be subtracted. That means the sign will change. So this becomes 0 and the second term will become plus 6x. Now that minus 12 remains. So that minus 12 has to be brought down. So minus 12. And now what number will you put here? So that when you multiply that number with x, you get 6x. Obviously, you have to put plus 6. Plus 6 into x is 6x. And that plus 6 has to be multiplied with minus 2. So you get minus 12. So now again, these two sign changes because you are subtracting. So this becomes 0 and 0. So that means your dividend, we won't write the entire dividend, we write f of x is equal to x minus 2 into x squared plus 5x plus 6. So now when you have this, the second term, you have to factorize that further to find what are the two factors. You already know that factorization, you have done that in standard 9. So how do you split this? You obviously will write this as 3x and 2x. Why do you write it as 3x and 2x? Because when you add, you need 5x. And when you multiply, it should be 6 into x squared, that is 6x squared. So you can write this as f of x is x minus 2. The second term would be x squared plus 3x plus 2x plus 6. So when you factorize that further, it becomes x minus 2, x into x plus 3, and 2 into x plus 3. So therefore x minus 2, x plus 3, or x plus 2 and x plus 3. So this gives you the entire factorized form of the given polynomial f of x. Now you have to look at the question and see whether the question is only to factorize or to solve. If the question was only factorize, I could have written x minus 2, x plus 2 and x plus 3 are the factors of the given polynomial f of x. As I told you, it's a third degree. So third degree equation, so three factors. Now the question is solve. So I will have to write one step further on this. Yeah, so as I told you, this is only factorization, but the question is solve. So I will write x minus 2 is 0 or x is equal to 2. X plus 2 is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus 2. And x plus 3 is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus 3. So you have 2 minus 2 and minus 3. 2 minus 2 and minus 3, they are all these solutions, three solutions to the given equation. So just like you solved and you got f of 2 is equal to 0, the remainder was 0. When you substitute minus 2 also, you will get the remainder as 0. And if you substitute minus 3 also, you will get the remainder as 0. But this is the method. First, one factor you have to find by trial and error, by looking at what is the factors of the constant term. And after you find that one factor, which we found as x minus 2, you have to use that factor and divide the given polynomial to find the other two factors. This is, you got a quadratic equation. And this you have to further split and factorize in that manner so that you get the answer. So that's the entire question number 3. Please solve this in your notebook. Now question number 4, class for question 4. They have given you a polynomial. And if you look closely at the polynomial, there is one p written here, which is an unknown variable. You don't know what is p. X is also, of course, that is the variable, p is an unknown. But they have given you that when this equation, this polynomial is divided by x plus 3, then the remainder is 5. So we have to make use of that statement. It means that if you write x plus 3 is 0 or x is minus 3, so when you substitute x is minus 3 in this equation, then the remainder is 5. It is not a factor. It is not giving you remainder 0. If it was given it is a factor, then this remainder would have been 0. But now it is given remainder is 5. So when you substitute x is minus 3, we do that, the remainder is 5. So when x is substituted, the only unknown will be p. So you get minus 27p, any negative number raised to odd number remains negative. So minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3 is minus 27p. Negative number into even number becomes positive. Why? Minus 3 into minus 3, it will become plus and then 9. So 9 into 9 is 81. So plus 81, this remains minus 12 and this is minus 10. When you solve that, you get p is equal to 2. So in this sum, they only asked you to find the value of p. So that's the final answer. What did you use? You have used this statement that x plus 3, when it divides the polynomial, remainder is 3. X plus 3 is 0, so x is minus 3. So when you substitute x is minus 3, then the remainder is 5. So that gives you the answer p is 2. Now the third sum which you did was very easy. Now this is similar to the third sum, but it is slightly lengthier. Usually such lengthy sums don't come directly like the third sum which you did, that is important, like that sums could come. Here you are given the polynomial and you are asked to find the factors. So obviously first the constant term is minus 10. So we know the factors of minus 10 are plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 5 and plus minus 10. Now when we use trial and error method f of 1, you substitute x is 1 in the given polynomial, there itself we are getting f of 1 is 0. It means that x is 1 or x minus 1 is a factor of f of x. So x minus 1 is a factor, we have got one factor. So the other factors we now need to find, like we did in the previous sum, by trial and error method. So how do you find the remaining factors? By division method. So now we are using division method to find the remaining two factors. So here I need to get 2x cubed. So what number should I write here so that that number into x is 2x cubed? It is 2x squared. Because 2x squared into x will give you 2x cubed. Then second, you have to write minus 2x squared. That is because 2x squared is multiplied by minus 1. Now these sign changes, when you are minusing this from this, the sign will change. So this will become 11x squared and this is 0. You have to get the next one term down. So it is minus x. So now what should I write here so that I get 11x squared here with plus sign? I should write plus 11x. So that's the second term. And then 11x has to be multiplied with minus 1. So it will be minus 11x. So when this, again when you change the sign, you're doing minus. So this will become minus and this will become plus. So now that becomes plus 10x. Plus 11x minus that. And this obviously is 0. Now the last term, I bring that down. That is minus 10. So what do I write up? So that I get 10x, when I multiply that term with x, I have to write plus 10. So when I write plus 10 there, it becomes 10x. And last, what is remaining? Minus 10. So now, when you subtract both those terms, the sign changes, the remainder is 0. So this means When we write the given polynomial f of x, the dividend f of x, you can say x minus 1 divisor into quotient 2x squared plus 11x plus 10. Now here, there is a unique peculiar problem. In this case, it is not possible for us to split this further into two factors. We can't imagine those numbers and split it. So there is a method to find the roots using formula. Of course, that chapter is also there for you in 10th standard. That chapter is known as quadratic equations. So that we will learn the formula now after you write this. We will learn the formula and see how this has to be split using formula so that you can find what are all the three answers. I told you it's a third degree equation. So you have to find three answers for the given polynomial. Now we had stopped the sum there. That is f of x is x minus 1, 2x squared, and we said that we can't split that. Some may ask, why not 10 and 1? 10 and 1 will give you 11x, but you need not 10, but you need 10 into 2, 2x squared. So you can't write 20x squared. So 20x squared you can't get by writing it as 10 and 1. So it can't be split that way. So we are using quadratic formula. So first of all, that part of the equation, there is already one factor you have found. This part only we write here, and we have to compare it by using ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. So x squared, the coefficient of x squared here is a, and the coefficient of x squared here is 2. So that means a is equal to 2. Similarly, bx, here it is 11x. So x and x is compared, so b is equal to 11. And the constant term c will be equal to the constant term here, that is 10. So when you can't split the quadratic equation or the second degree equation, we are going to use this formula to find the two solutions. This is second degree equation, so you will get two solutions by using this formula. X is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac upon 2a, where your a, b and c you found by comparing it with the quadratic part which you couldn't split. So now b minus b, so minus 11 plus minus root of b squared, 11 squared minus 4 times a is 2 and c is 10. So 121 minus 80, root of 41. Minus 11 plus minus root 41. Now you have to look in page 258 of your Anish tutorial textbook. You have square root table. That table will be given to you in the exams, even in school, even in class, even in boards. So that square root table, you will find root of 41 under 0 is 6.403. So x is minus 11 plus minus 6.403 upon 4. So minus 11 plus 6.403 upon 4. First we take the plus part and second we take the minus part. So this, when you add, you get plus 4.597 upon 4, which you round it off to two decimals, it becomes 1.15. That is the second solution. And the same equation, minus 11, now with the minus sign, 6.6403 upon 4, that is minus 17.403 upon 4, it gives you minus 4.35. So, first we had factorized and found x is 1, so x minus 1 is 0 or x is 1, and the second value is x is 1.15, and the third value is minus 4.35. Now students, in the next video we will continue with the sums. I am not giving you any homework because I know that I have to solve some more sums. Only then you will understand this method better and you will be able to do the homework. So homework I will give it to you next time, that is on Tuesday. That time Tuesday 7th April I will give you the homework when I solve two more videos. So this all you copy it in your notebook and write it down. This method you just go through it, learn it. We will solve more sums and then do the homework sums.